Things are looking up out there. Traffic numbers are high, especially in general and business aviation.
Now, that's right. The rebound is strong. According to data from FlightAware, business aviation is up 81% from last year at this time. Pretty low threshold, but it's even up 11.5% compared to the same period in 2019. That's measuring only turbine Part 91 and 135 operations. So I'm on the road this week with AOP President and CEO Mark Baker. We've been out and about in the middle and the southeastern part of the country talking to some aviation influencers and trying to understand what's happening in the marketplace, particularly around business aviation. And what we've seen and heard on the frequency, seen on the ramps, is a lot of activity by light turbine aircraft, turboprops, light jets, but also some high-end piston aircraft out and about conducting business. But one thing we haven't seen much of are the really big intercontinental jets, the Gulfstreams and the Falcons of the world. Seem to be in the hangars because of COVID. International travel restrictions have meant that a lot of corporations that might typically be making a lot of international trips are not doing so because of those restrictions. But regardless, when it comes to domestic travel, though, there is a big uptick in activity, and it's really nice to see. And a lot of that uptick in activity is also reflected in the demand for used aircraft. If you've tried to find a good used airplane, you already know that the market is hot. VREF calls it a feeding frenzy. The piston fixed wing market is up 15% to 35% compared to last year. Twin engine aircraft, which had been in the doldrums, are also up in demand. The Baron 55 at the top of that list. Light to medium sized jets are selling fast, as are single engine turboprops. And based on VREF valuations, the top three most desired piston aircraft are, get this, the Cessna 182, the 172, and the mighty A36 Bonanza. You can check out VREF aircraft prices on our website if you're an AOPA member. And by the way, a 1970s era 172 would set you back about $90,000 if you can find one. So Alyssa makes me feel bad, but I sold my 1977 172 for about $43,000. Okay, granted, that was 20 years ago, but when I now see that they're going for $90,000, pretty impressive.
That is. Yeah. Now, I mean, you could always put your Bonanza up, although I don't see you ever parting with that.